Just take this wing fly off and work with it later. Yeah, that's an interesting job.
Did I talk to get a copy of the tape?
You're You were going down there.
No, that was Mahoney. They went down there. Well, we did on vacation.
Oh, on vacation.
That was
the
last time I talked to him. Yeah, that's the next 10 years. It was the journey.
It's right there.
Computer.
Thank you.
Wait a minute.
Everyone, please take your seats.
Welcome you all to the dedication and opening of the West Seattle Low-Level Bridge. This bridge completes a very vital link between communities that provides for a much more efficient roadway and waterway. And we have built a very innovative bridge here, and we're all very happy that you've joined us. It takes a lot of people to pull a project like this off. Some of them
really came together to make this bridge a reality. We're celebrating the skill and the dedication of our city employees and contractors. We're celebrating the spirit of community involvement reflected in all the groups that are here today. And most of all, we're celebrating the spirit of innovation in this city, because this is the first bridge of its kind anywhere in the world. Obviously, there are a lot of people involved in making this bridge a reality. Those that are here and all of you who are out in front of me. But I'd like to just name a couple of them I think who deserve a lot of credit. Most of all, my former colleague, Jeanette Williams. Engineering department, especially retired Director of Engineering Services, Bruce Wassell. Kurt Johnson, Acting Director of Engineering Services. Where are you? Okay. Frank Janaganachi, the project manager. And the construction engineers, Dan McKillop, John Buswell, Steve Pacola, and Bill Frederick. Now, this bridge represents a tremendous investment, an investment in the future of our city, and its impact will be felt in ways too numerous to mention. But the bottom line is this: today is a great day for the entire community, from the commuters and the bicyclists who cross this river, to the ships and the truckers who rely on the Duwamish for their livelihood. And no matter where you are or who you are, this bridge and this day is a cause for celebration. So on behalf of the City of Seattle, along with George Benson, who helped provide the parting of the clouds and no rain right now, we say let's celebrate. It's a time for fun. It's a time to celebrate the hard work and the good endeavors of all. Thank you very much.
Have been extremely instrumental in the success of this project. City Council Member George Benson, now the Chair of the Transportation Committee, helped ensure that the design and construction of the bridge was scrutinized very carefully. That's really important when you're spending millions of dollars of the taxpayers' money to design and construct something that's new, something that hasn't been tried before. And he pushed us to do the very best work possible. That's what we've done, and the result is an innovative engineering feat that we can all be very proud of. Following George, we'll hear from Jeanette Williams. When the tough decisions were being made, when the long meetings and the compromising was going on, Jeanette was the head of the Transportation Committee, and she led the council in support of building a new bridge to replace the old one. She was extremely influential in obtaining the funding and holding together the different agencies that it took to pull this project on. We're here today because of her belief in the project and in her insistence that we did analysis and study. She's really been a champion of this bridge from the very beginning. So first we'll hear from Councilman Benson and then former council member Jeanette Williams.
Good afternoon. The question was raised
And where were you on the Sunday morning that Chavez wiped off the bridge? Sort of like, where were you on Pearl Harbor Day? I had just completed my weekly pilgrimage to the North Transfer Station to make a deposit. This was before recycling. And I was hailed down by telephone by a former employee, Art Moronic, who says, guess what happened to the bridge? And so instead of going to church that morning, I came out here to look at the bridge. So I'm proud to be included in this ceremony. I am here by virtue of my position as chairman of the Transportation Committee of the City Council. We've all looked forward to this day, but the real mover, which we must pay tribute to for this accomplishment, is my predecessor, Jeanette Williams, who pursued both bridges, not one, but both bridges, for years. To her must go the credit. To our city engineers and our consultants who have labored to see that this state-of-the-art bridge is successful, we tender our deepest thanks. To Nicholson Machinery and the Kiewit family of companies that converted the engineers' plans into reality, we acknowledge the good works. To the business community of Harbor Island, as well as the residents of West Seattle, who use this bridge, I say it's about time. To the bicyclists who have now a chance to drive the straight road, I say, wasn't the shuttle great? And finally, there will be another permanent access to Harbor Island and West Seattle, one that will greatly improve the reliability of the corridor. I'm sure that we are all glad to be here this afternoon at the culmination of this project. Thanks very much.
Try this one again. Thank you, Gary. This is a very special bridge, of course. And this is a very special day, of course. I think what is really so tremendous about this particular bridge is that if you compare it to this one up here, this is almost a breeze to see that with Bill as compared to what we are facing with this very unique structure here today. And the thanks goes to the engineering department and all the consultants that did work so long and so hard and so successfully to get everything done on schedule and under budget. And it, so was the story of this bridge all the way through from the very beginning. However, it was not always that easy getting it started. And we had the naysayers. Believe me, we had the naysayers. We had a very prestigious group, actually. And a former mayor and even our present mayor had his doubts about where we were going. I might say with this particular bridge, our now head of the transportation had his doubts about where we were going. It seems to me that the Harbor Island Improvement Association had doubts about where we were going. But we had some very special people too. I think we have to remember the Port of Seattle was a big actor in this. Without the port and their assistance, it wouldn't have happened. I think we have to remember the waterway users, Harold is here, bless his heart, to stalwart all the way through this, and I'm not going to try and mention them. There were so many. But they recognize that if we're looking for a good future and a good use of the Duwamish waterway and to do it the way it should be done, this is what we had to do, and so we did. So for this very special group of people, we do say thank you. But I think most of all, for myself, I'd like to say a very special thank you to a very special group of people. That is the Seattle Engineering Department. They are great people to work with. They have been, they are, and they will be. So what I would like to say to Gary, representing all the engineering department, a job well done.
Magnitude takes more than one jurisdiction, more than one agency, more than one point of view. One of the people who made sure that the interests of the citizens of Seattle, and particularly the interests of the people who live in West Seattle, Senator Bill Talmadge. He had considerable influence in facilitating an open process in the design of this project. Senator Talmadge.
Testimonials to Jeanette Williams and all the other people that have had a great say in making this project happen. I'm mindful of Jeanette's work on the high-level bridge and the low-level bridge along the lines of an old story about a cabinet meeting President Lincoln had. President Lincoln heard from all the members of the cabinet, and all of them said a particular proposal was a bad idea. So the president put the issue to a vote in his cabinet. The vote was taken, and he said, that's five no's and one aye. The ayes have it. Very reminiscent of Jeanette's efforts on this. She's decided that this should happen, and indeed she did, and should be happy for that. I, along with Gary Zarker, I think we're the only two West Seattle residents that are up here at the front. I think, speaking for all of the people of West Seattle, we've seen ourselves very often as an island because we've been so cut off at times from the rest of the city. Now with the high-level bridge and this low-level bridge, the people of West Seattle are no longer an island, but again, we are a part of the city of Seattle. We're a peninsula, and we are mindful of the fact that we've now finished two of the three links to the peninsula of Southwest Seattle. We have one more to go that's a little bit farther south from here, but I think we're going to have a dedication ceremony like this one sometime very soon. And I think when that is completed, the people of Southwest Seattle will have their complete link to the rest of the city and the rest of the county. The state, the county, the Port of Seattle, the city, all of these jurisdictions have worked to make this possible. And for the people of West Seattle, I know it's a very desirable thing to have both our high-level bridge and now this low-level bridge. And I know the people who are bicyclists are real happy to see that shuttle disappear once and for all. Thank you.
Yeah. Putting that kind of money together is never an easy task, and especially for a project like this. It was the Port of Seattle that provided the final and vital funding link for the low-level bridge, increasing its original obligation by several million dollars. The state played an important role in helping us obtain Federal Highway Administration funding. With us from the Port of Seattle is Patricia Davis and the District 1 engineer from the State Department of Transportation, Ron Anderson.
Thank you, Bev. On behalf of the Port of Seattle Commission, President Jack Block, who was unable to be here, unfortunately, because he had a vital role to play in this bridge, and of the staff of the Port of Seattle, I'm very proud to be here to help celebrate the opening of this bridge. The Port of Seattle had a primary commitment of $4 million to this bridge early on as a result of the building of the top high-level bridge. But I have to say it's a real tribute to people like Jeanette Williams particularly and the entire council of the City of Seattle that they managed to extract at great effort and with a lot of arm twisting and bloodshed another $3 million. So we're very proud of our contribution, and Norm is back here laughing his head off about this, but it worked. And the reason, aside from their charming personalities, that it worked, is that the Port of Seattle has had a long-term commitment to waterborne commerce. And we wanted very badly to open this Duwamish waterway up to the best possible extension so that shipping could continue to come and go up and down the Duwamish. And it is on behalf of that particularly, as well as the businesses here in Harbor Island, and as an effort to relieve road congestion as well, that we were willing to contribute that much more out of our very tight budget, despite what you think. It lowered our profit margin from $4 million to $1 million that year. But it was money well spent, and that was money that helped generate more in terms of jobs, waterborne commerce, and revenues outside of the port itself to continue to keep our city what it is, a diverse mix of a whole lot of kinds of businesses, and one of the primary ones is our marine side and our marine businesses. So thank you very much for being here, and we're proud to have had a part in making this bridge happen. Thank you.
Department of Transportation, the Transportation Commission, the Secretary of Transportation, Dwayne Berenson, and our Department of Local Programs, we also would like to extend our congratulations for this magnificent project. We would like to also extend special appreciation to Bruce Wassell and to Frank Y for their outstanding effort, diligence, and cooperation in working with our department and the Federal Highways Administration making this project a reality. This is becoming a waterway of bridges, and we have one more important project that we're working on that's left to remain. That's the First Avenue South Bridge. The City of Seattle and the Department of Transportation are working cooperatively in the design that will lead to the construction of this important structure. So again, congratulations, and thank you so much for the opportunity to participate.
Talmadge's role in helping to ensure that the community had a voice in this project. The engineering department in the City of Seattle is responsive to the citizens it serves. The next three individuals have been leaders as community representatives, working on the project from the design phase through construction. Chuck Holland has represented the waterway users. This group played a very important role in moving forward with a new bridge rather than just rehabilitating the old one. Bill Crepane has been the spokesperson for Harbor Island interests. These people have had to endure over 2 years of detouring over the high-level bridge for access to their businesses. We appreciate their cooperation and their patience. Dick Kennedy represented the entire West Seattle community from the planning and construction of the high-level through this project. So now we'll hear from the community representative.
Represent today the Duwamish waterway users. To us, the bridge is vital, as the waterway is our highway upriver, where Seattle's industrial heartland is. Over the 20 largest businesses that are upriver depend on the waterway, generate over 2,700 jobs with an annual payroll of over $55 million. As you view the river, you'll see a variety of ships, barges, and boats. There'll be even more in the future. The bridge creates many opportunities for future generations. But just as importantly, the bridge demonstrates what has been accomplished here in Seattle, that there is teamwork when all the groups get together on a problem that we faced back in 1979 when the ship hit the span. I'd now like to briefly recognize and thank some of those people that were part of this teamwork. First, Jeanette Williams, without whose efforts these bridges may never have become a reality. Not enough can be said of all she did to bring about the completion of the high-level bridge and now this new low-level bridge. Thank you, Jeanette. Let's give her an extra applause. Pat Davis, prior to her election to the Port of Seattle Commission, Pat recognized the need for improved Duwamish waterway navigation and thus helped direct this project since its beginning. Likewise, her fellow commissioners Jack Block and Paige Miller were very much involved. The City Council, Gary Grant and Greg Nichols of the King County Council, and Lynn Taylor, formerly with the Port of Seattle. Bruce Wassell and Frankie Yanagimachi, you've heard their names mentioned too. I'd like to add them again. The one thing about Frank is he was involved with this project and he got called away because of Desert Storm. And those of us that were on the Bridge Oversight Review Committee were really glad when he could return to finish the project, because on the committee we gave him a lot of advice and he always used it. For the U.S. Coast Guard, John Mixell has always been an integral part of the project. I'd like to also, on behalf of my company, Jones Stevedoring Company, thank Kent Worley and Dennis Weaver of Kiewit Global Construction Company. A lot of times we had closures on the waterway when we had to get the ships upriver in order to bring cargo that was essential for our community. And they saw to it that these delays were as minimal as possible. Other people that were involved that are upriver I'd like to mention are Dave Larson of Duwamish Shipyard, Bill Crepane, Fisher Companies, Ken Roan, Ashgrove Cement, Jim Vanderveen at Crowley Maritime, Richard Ladwick, James Hardy and Company, and the Longshoremen, Locals 19 and 52. All of these people were involved with this project from the very beginning. And finally, I think a special thanks goes from all of us to the Seattle Chamber of Commerce. Its Maritime Committee was very much involved, but was really led by staff members Mike Lewis and Jackie Reed. They deserve recognition for their diligent hard work. My thanks to everyone who is here today who played a part in having this bridge constructed. We have before us a bridge that will not only serve us well in our lifetime, but for future generations. Thank you.
Yes, as chairman of the Harbor Island Improvement Association and a member of the West Seattle Freeway Design and Construction Oversight Committee, I would like to extend my hearty congratulations to the City of Seattle for a job very well done. When I look at this project, I can't help but think of an epic movie, with today being its premier showing. It's a fascinating story, nearly a decade in the making, conceived and authored by visionary community leaders, especially Jeanette Williams. It was made possible by a committed group of sponsors, talented principal actors, strong supporting staff, and an able production crew. The principal storyline is one of new beginnings in terms of cooperation, friendship, and technology. A special production like this does not occur without frustration, but fortunately that's all behind us. Many special credits are due, most notably to the Seattle Engineering Department and its project manager, Frank Yanagamachi. I'm sure that future generations will come to enjoy and appreciate this good work. Well, enough said. I think you get the picture. Let's enjoy the production and share the pride. Thank you.
The West Seattle Chamber of Commerce, I first want to again thank all of these folks behind me. I'm not going to do it individually. I think you've all heard their names. There are two other people that have been mentioned several times that you have not seen. First, Frank Yanagamachi. Come on up here, Frank. I think we need to know who you are. I just wanted to come up here in front. Bruce Walsell, where'd you go? Come on up here. These men are terrifically responsible for what has been done. Let's have one more big hand for them. The Harbor Island people, I want to say welcome back to West Seattle. We have a lot of people that live in West Seattle that work on Harbor Island that have had to go almost to Rainier Valley to go to work. Starting today, they'll be able to go directly to work, and we are very pleased with this job that's been done. We thank Kiewit Global, everyone that's had a part. It's a beautiful job, and thank you very much.
You can't have a project like this one without a stellar design team. Tom Kane's engineering leadership has been extremely valuable. ABKJ worked on the high-level bridge design, and through Tom's initiative and guidance, the design team undertook the challenge of this low-level bridge and has done an outstanding job. Perseverance overcame the many obstacles associated with this kind of project. Tom's drive and dedication as a professional engineer has made this a success. Tom Kane.
Give my congratulations to the Seattle Engineering Department, the City of Seattle, for the project, not only this movable bridge or the high-level bridge, for a successfully completed project, particularly to the Bruce and Frank that's already been mentioned. You know, the City of Seattle, over the years, has done some outstanding things, and they've been well recognized in the community. You know that years ago they took a hill out there called the Denny Regrade and sluiced it down and made a plateau out there for further growth to the north. They've done They've done things like build a Harbor Island, the largest man-made island in the United States, by dredging. The city of Seattle has been at the forefront of many projects. The seawall along the central waterfront was built in precast elements long before precast was even perceived in most other parts of the country. But I'd like to say that on this bridge, the movable bridge, the low-level swing bridge, the West Seattle swing bridge, we'd like to hold that a little piece of the album available for that, because from the number of responses and interest we're getting from engineers all over the world, I think this is going to have a place along with some of those other classic programs. They've asked us why we designed this particular type of bridge. And there's several reasons. One, we wanted compatibility with the segmental high-level bridge. Secondly, we wanted a riding surface that was not grading, that was solid, and was safety-free. We wanted additional vertical clearance underneath the channel. We wanted to widen the channel, and it looked to us after a number of studies that this was the bridge, both from a cost and a functional standpoint, that would serve the purpose. You know, people have also asked, well, what about the hydraulic system? And the hydraulic system is an old, well-known system. It's been established over the years, but it has not been put into use in movable bridges for a while. But when I was in London several years ago, you've all seen, many of you have seen the Tower Bridge over there. That Tower Bridge had a hydraulic system that lasted for well over 80 years. It opened 6,100 times in the first 3 weeks. So we have an oil hydraulic system here that we have a lot of confidence in. And last, I'd like to say that these bridges, under the design of a bridge in this complexity, take the work of an entire team. And we were certainly blessed with one of the outstanding teams in the country. We have assembled that team to bring each discipline in. There's a number of firms that are represented here today. Several people that I'd just like to mention, and they're among you out there, from our own firm of Anderson, Bjornstedt, Kane & Jacobs. Our chief engineer, John Clark, is out there. Had a tremendous amount of contribution. Bob Curry, who is out in the audience today, as our field construction person and advisor all through the course of the contract. For the hydraulics, Hamilton Engineering was extremely involved all the way through and added their expertise. And we could go on. But it's a team effort. It isn't just one person. This bridge is too complex and it's too grand for one person. Again, we wouldn't have been able to make it possible without the cooperation and the confidence of the city of Seattle. And with that, I'll turn it over to Gary Zarker, the Director of Engineering. And again, I'd just like to say, Gary, we appreciate very much your confidence in the design team that you selected.
He'd like to get up without me saying anything about him, but I think I will anyway. You've heard a lot of credit given to the City of Seattle and to the Seattle Engineering Department for the success of this project. Well, a great deal of the credit goes to Gary Zarker. Under Gary's strong leadership and direction, the Seattle Engineering Department is more vital and more responsive than it's probably ever been in its history. The director of the Seattle Engineering Department, Gary Zarker.
Thank you, Gary. Thank you for all of the nice remarks that have been made about the engineering department. This really is a very proud moment for the Seattle Engineering Department. Tom's exactly right. This department has taken on some very unusual, innovative projects over the years. And we really get a big kick out of completing projects. Most of the time, the projects we do are very small ones, but on occasion, we do get involved in some really big ones. Tom was right. We looked across the water. That island over there was created by the Seattle Engineering Department. And this high-level bridge that brings West Seattle neighborhoods closer to the city, that was our project just a few years ago. The project we're celebrating today
is a really special one, though. You've heard some of the other speakers talk about the unusual aspects, the unique aspects of this bridge. Folks who work in public works rarely get this kind of opportunity to work on cutting-edge technology. Our people, and I know the members of the design and the construction teams, feel especially proud to have been associated with something of this scale that no one else in the world has really ever done. As public projects go, this was a high-risk endeavor. We are very grateful that our elected officials had the confidence in us and encouraged us to take this innovative project on. I particularly want to thank Norm Rice, George Benson, and also Jeanette Williams, who was clearly the person who ponchoed this project through and secured the arrangements with all of the other governments that helped us. If you haven't figured it out yet, this is clearly Jeanette Williams' bridge. Any big project like this has to be a team effort to be successful. We had a great group of people to work with. Tom Kane, who led the design team from ABKJ, also was the leader of the high-level bridge design team, did an outstanding job. Our friends and partners from Kiewit Global, who were the principal contractors, stretched themselves and did a kind of a major construction project that even a big international firm like that found to be a stretch. I'm especially proud of the team the engineering department assigned. Bruce Wassell, who you've heard has recently moved on to the private sector, was just a genius of a public sector, public works manager. He put this team together and he shepherded this project through some very rough waters. Frank Yanagamachi, who also has been mentioned, has been the project manager of this thing probably for many more years than he cares to remember. But he brought it through today, too. And finally, Dan McKillop is the senior resident engineer on this project, and he's the guy that we seem to turn to whenever we have a big project like this that really stretches us and is so important to the community. There are so many people that you need to thank in this that there just isn't time. But I'm very proud of all of you, and I'm very appreciative of all the efforts that you made. This bridge is now ready to open. You can see around you that we still have a little bit of construction work to do, but we have an obligation to open this bridge to the motoring public just as soon as we feel absolutely certain that it is safe to do so. Contrary to what you may have seen in the news media recently, this bridge is safe and it's ready to open. So without further ado, let's get on with it.
So listen up. We are going to close the bridge. If you look off to the sides, you should be able to see the fire department boat and the tug from Foss. What everyone needs to do who is walking is move to the pedestrian part of the bridge. The band is going to lead a procession. In order to do that, we have to move the chair. So if everyone could very quickly...
Thank you.
Bye, Mom.